the nuclear fuel cycle is to a large extent the uranium cycle, and therefore it is important to spend a bit of time on the chemistry of uranium before we look in the detail into the fuel cycle. My name is Thierry Wyss, and I will tell you some more about it. Uranium is the 19th second element in the periodic table, and it can be found at the far end. As you may recall from secondary school, the periodic table groups the elements according to the filling of the electron shells. Uranium belongs to the actinide series that consists of actinium and the 14 elements of the 5F block, including plutonium and thorium. In uranium, the electrons occupy 7 shells, the 5th, 6th, and 7th being partially filled due to their close energy. Uranium has 2 electrons in the 7S subshell, 1 electron in the 6D subshell, and 3 in the 5F subshell. As a result, uranium can exhibit a variety of valence states. If the 7S and the 1,6D electrons are removed, uranium has a 3+ valence state, and if then the 5F electrons are subsequently removed, a 4+, 5+, and 6+ state is obtained. The 6+ state has the radon noble gas electron configuration, which is extremely stable. The valence state of uranium has a strong influence on the physical property of the compounds. For example, the tetrafluoride is a solid salt which just melts below 1000 degrees Celsius and boils just above 1400 degrees Celsius. The hexafluoride, in contrast, sublimes around 50 degrees Celsius to form a gas before melting. Uranium dioxide is one of the most important compounds in the nuclear fuel cycle. It is found as the mineral uraninite in nature, and it is the fuel of most nuclear reactors. Uranium dioxide is an extremely stable compound. It melts at a very high temperature of 2860 degrees Celsius. Its crystal structure is composed of regular cubic arrangement of the uranium 4+ atoms, indicated in blue, and oxygen 2- atoms in red, with uranium on the corners and the faces of the cube, and the oxygens regularly arranged inside the cube. If we zoom in on the oxygen sublattice, you can see that only half of the oxygen cubes are filled with uranium. So the uranium dioxide structure has space to accommodate other atoms, becoming non-stoichiometric. For example, extra oxygen in the empty cubes, indicated by the red plus symbol. For this to happen, 2 uranium atoms are further oxidized to 5+, in order to keep electron neutrality. The oxygen over uranium ratio will thus become larger than 2, which is called hyperstoichiometric. In the same way, uranium can be reduced to +3, accompanied by the creation of a vacant oxygen position in the crystal lattice, indicated by the black square, and so forms a hypostoichiometric compound. This means that UO2 can have a very large deviation from the stoichiometric composition at high temperature, which has a significant effect on its properties. The valence state of uranium also has an impact on the dissolution behavior. The tetravalent uranium compounds are very insoluble, and UO2 can only be brought into solution with extremely strong acids, such as a concentrated nitric acid. Dissolubility can be well demonstrated by a so-called EH-pH diagram that shows the stability domains as a function of the acidity, the pH, and the electron affinity of the solution, the EH. In the area between the 2 red dotted lines, showing the stability domain of water, there are 2 main fields, the solid uranium dioxide, indicated by the black field, and a variety of hexavalent uranium aqueous species that are grouped in the blue field. As you can see now, in most of waters on the surface of the Earth, hexavalent is stable in solution. Uranium dioxide is only stable in water that are isolated from atmosphere. The hexavalent uranium forms a very stable molecule in solution, the so-called uranyl oxocation. This is a linear molecule with a very strong triple bond between uranium and oxygen. Since the space around the positively charged uranium is free, all the ligands can bind to the molecule in the equatorial plane. Here you can see the uranyl nitride molecule, for example. In this molecule, 2 nitride ligands bind to the uranyl with 2 oxygen each, giving the uranium a 6-fold octahedral coordination. When the uranium precipitates from the solution, it forms uranyl silts with the same octahedral structure around the uranium. All in all, we can say that the nuclear fuel cycle has very much to do with the conversion between chemical forms of uranium in order to purify, enrich, fabricate, and dispose the fuel. You can see the most important compounds here. In the next lecture, we will elaborate on their role in the nuclear fuel cycle.